Today is the 30th of May, 2022. Happy Memorial Day. Thanks for tuning in to my official YouTube channel. Make sure to subscribe to my official YouTube channel and like my official YouTube videos if you're going to leave a comment at all. Make sure to have etiquette and respect. Go to my website, www.susanmeling.com. So today's Memorial Day. And, you know, during the time frame of the year of 2008 into 2009, I dealt with a lot of problems needlessly because people who had blamed me for stuff that wasn't my fault in those particular references, such as that CID interrogation that I dealt with where I was and still remain completely innocent because of the fact that hadn't been seeing that individual for more than 2 days at that point, the additional factors of how, unlike certain individuals, I went above and beyond what any normal person would as an ex. Additionally, as to not just the first, though also the second and final separation, though there's that dress blues factor that, you know, I didn't know anything about until in 2008 at the funeral home is when I actually learned in the official capacity about the rack, because I wasn't informed of that. And so that wasn't informed to me until the chief warrant officer tree. And so it would be really weird to ever think that anybody who would have ever been active duty and or National Guard and or reservist and or veteran would ever wrongfully blame someone who wouldn't have that knowledge, because in order to have that knowledge, that would require learning all the ribbons and medals instead. And then it would be really messed up if anybody who would ever think that would be correct in comparison to actually blaming the individual who would be wrong for doing so. Because it would make no sense for anybody to ever blame my son and or my daughter or myself in that reference, because why would I know? I didn't graduate basic training. And then there's the knowledge as to how the justice of the peace occurred. I mean, I don't know what level of common sense would be needed, because each and every male and female has been birthed by a mom. And so whether you like your mom or not, it is one of those common sense factors, if you have human decency, to ever think about that, because why would any individual ever think in those capacities outside of those realms? I mean, if I actually had to point that out, especially as many times as I've talked about it in person, face to face, in person, and or in regards of through my official YouTube videos and or my journal blog, The Ornery PSA, through my website, www.susanmeling.com, which is the same as www.ladydorybell.com. I don't know what levels of intelligence would be considered problematic in reference to individuals that would be capable to read that and hear that and even discuss with others about that truth and have that verification as to those situations. I don't know what that would translate to in regards of intellectual capacities, because if I were to ever have dealt with that, you know, such as Excalibur Fair, you know, that sort of situation, I mean, then that lets certain individuals think about certain factors. Because if that's actually ever been an issue where I wasn't informed until essentially February of 2008 is when I was informed by someone who was active duty, in comparison, So only when I was informed in February of 2008 would be when I knew about all of those medals and ribbons. And so while I said I wouldn't be surprised, that doesn't change the fact that I wouldn't be surprised would translate to not knowing. I would think that that would be common sense to figure that out. So I had seen a video and a couple of postings from E equals MC squared as far as discussions he's had that were videotaped and or postings. And it says that, you know, heroes, didn't get to meet with his heroes, which would be, you know, I don't even know how to put that in words when you really think about it, because unlike the stereotype regarding certain individuals who have different color hair and then tattoos and so on and so forth, and even my outfits, I mean, I don't know what that would translate to when you really think about intellectual capacities to ever actually not realize that February 2008, being informed by a Chief Warrant Officer Tree would be different than some random individual. I mean, I don't know how many people would actually have to think about that. And or in reference to my right as far as my choice because of that Bronze Star situation, I don't know what levels of intelligence would need to be figured out, because if you look at the pictures of the JCPenney portraits, that's what he walked around in, and that's what he had in military installations. And so, I mean, I'm all about earned valor. And so it would be very difficult for me to ever think that anybody who would ever think otherwise would be weird. You know, similarly to in basic training when I refused to call myself something because I didn't graduate basic training, also because I could see as to that particular factor. Because now you have the U.S. Space Force that has been formulated regarding the Department of Defense, as far as that's concerned. And yeah, when you think about it, you know, that Department of Defense wording to the U.S. Space Force and NASA and SpaceX and Blue Origin, it does make sense that, you know, you wouldn't have a problem with someone who would knowingly at the age of 17, and since being 17, even after all the different situations, still maintaining that stance as to acknowledging that I didn't graduate basic training, because how important could that be with that formulation of the U.S. Space Force, certain aspects as to the knowledge such as Irving 2011, and then there's the oceanic waters as far as how the U.S. Navy has released certain videos as to what pilots would have seen and people on the deck of the boats. Now, most likely, you know, those who would go scuba diving and or those who would be in a submarine, well, they wouldn't necessarily see that in the sky. Common sense would dictate that they would see that in the sky if they were above the water. That would probably make sense. However, I don't want to assume. Then there's those factors as to, you know, my own work regarding scuba diving, and, you know, because I know better as far as that's concerned when it comes to situations. And I mean, why would anybody ever be upset that they wouldn't have to handle certain situations themselves? I mean, that common sense factor, you know, when you take in consideration my childhood and going out to the oceanic waters and my teenage years, some of them going out to the oceanic waters, and then as a biological adult, I mean, especially when you think about so many other situations going on, I don't know, then there's my, you know, scuba diving where I earned 26 scuba diving certifications, and did all this work by myself. And while I wouldn't be capable to ever understand why any person would ever be envious of that, mainly because I've seen it in person, face to whatever you want to call that in person. And so, you know, common sense would dictate, sure, I'm only 5'4". At most, you know, I mean, aside from after Irving in reference to 2011, sure, I, you know, I'm small, but, you know, when I used to play football with some guys back in New Jersey, I enjoyed playing with the bigger guys because, you know, I just was that way. And it worked out for the team I was on. So I would get the ball randomly and, you know, these guys being usually in high school and college. So, you know, at first they'd start out with, oh, you're so cute. And I'd just, you know, real quick, move out of the way. And then, you know, sort of would have use as a child. And then, you know, when they would get, oh, lucky whatever, you just are itchy whatever. Oh, no, that's okay. No, now the guys on my team, they always knew. They always knew I was a little rambunctious as a child. So there was one time where a guy was like, oh, aren't you cute? I have a little sister that's, you know, about your size. And, you know, I was, you know, a whopping, you know, 5 years old, man. And so the guys in the neighborhood, they were just like, So there's this funny YouTube video of, Donald Trump and as Deadpool or something like that, and like the news media. And there's this female and she's just got her whatever doohickey mabob. And so instead of having a little doohickey mabob, it was kind of like, No, it's okay. And so that next time, you know, get the football down and it's, you know, hut, hut. And then, you know, I grabbed the football and I jumped on the guy's, you know, thigh and then bounced off and then started running and made a touchdown. It was like, yeah. So, you know, then there was another time where this guy, he was in college and I was, you know, a whole 5.5 years old. So 5.5 years old. And so, you know, he did the typical football thing, and I literally ran through, ducked down real low, and just took off running, and then stood up and had the football. I was like, yeah, that's right. Boom, touchdown. What? And so, you know, in that reference of you know, scuba diving and knowing my gear, you know, I know that there's the floor as to the various areas of the oceanic waters. Usually you don't want to do that though, because you don't want to stir up that silt. It mucks it up for a bunch of others. So, you know, I went, earned my 26 scuba diving certifications, and, you know, most people didn't really have any issues with the silt. And then there was when I went to the Gulf of Mexico and, you know, whatever, because it's not like anybody would have an issue regarding military guys not having to deal with that. I mean, clearing out the waters in the state of Texas, so that way that's not an issue because, I mean, would it be considered Coast Guard? Would it be considered Marines? Would it be considered Navy? I mean, you know, hot springs, reservoirs, quarries, lakes, you know, in comparison, I don't know, because there's like this whole oceanic area that seems whatever. But then there's the Gulf of Mexico, And you know, I mean, sure, but you know, there's that issue regarding turf. And then there's that same thing regarding, well, sure, you know, did any military guys really want to deal with lobster bisque? I mean, you know, if you really, really think about the lobsters, the three of them that are called lobster bisque, like one is called lob, one is called stir, and one is called bisque. Because that, I mean, anybody who's seen a coral reef, it's just at the bottom of the oceanic area over there with a forming underwater volcano nearby, you know, with the heat from that. Anybody who's ever been near a volcano, but it's underwater, so you know, how hot could it really be other than it's capable to boil the area of water. And you know, I mean, how hot would the temperature actually have to be when you really think about a underwater volcano compared to on the surface? I mean, you have on the surface, you know, air is obviously thinner than water. Duh. In comparison. And so just think, how hot could that water really be? You know, and handling stuff, you know, because sure, I'm only 5'4". Yeah. So my biological mother had this saying when I was a child, and she said, big things come in small packages such as TNT and dynamite. And so, you know, I just handled stuff, you know, I mean, because who would actually want to deal with that, you know? Because just think of how big one of those lobsters truthfully were. Because anybody, so if you need a viewpoint for those who don't scuba dive or snorkel, but especially scuba dive, so you could go to like the Grand Canyon, okay? And so that's like a coral reef where I was at, as far as the bottom of that area of the Atlantic, part of the oceanic waters. That's kind of like a coral reef. Even in regards of when I was out in the Gulf of Mexico, there's this picture of a coral reef that I had, you know, it's almost like the Little Mermaid, we're looking up and stuff like that. And so that's like a coral reef. Just get at the bottom of the gully area or whatever it's called. I don't think it's called a plateau, but it's somewhere around there, and just stand there, and that's kind of, you know, and so then find an area where you could see, you know, like a ridge or something. And that's kind of, you know, so any of the military guys, you know, even the most .. of the most .. guys, you know, they'd prefer to have dealt with that in comparison to, you know, me. I mean, you know, I mean, there's a lot of water in the ocean. And so that can happen if you prefer. I don't recommend it, mainly again, because, well, sure, you could go to Red Lobster and you could see the little baby ones. The little teeny tiny itsy bitsy ones, you know? There's lobster bisque. And so again, you could go to like the Grand Canyon. And it really doesn't matter which area of the Grand Canyon, mainly because there's the Gulf of Mexico area, okay, where I landed at the bottom of the Gulf of Mexico. And then you have the Atlantic area of the oceanic waters out from Boca. So any individual that, you know, I mean, I personally don't see why, and I haven't seen why any individual would ever really be jealous of my scuba diving, because why would I ever think that? You know, and then just think as far as like those .. scuba divers, well, there's still the water above the the Grand Canyon top part? Because remember, that's just a coral reef as to what I was looking at. And anybody who has got scuba diving obviously knows that there's more water above the coral reef. It's not an aquarium, it's the oceanic waters. So, you know, I mean, it'd be like, you know, this, so right here, there's this molding, okay? Right here, it'd be like, well, there's a little coral reef right there, okay? Or in a different reference, the Vandenberg, okay? But this is where it landed. And then there's all that water all the way up to the ceiling, you know? And anybody who's been in a submarine and seen certain species of fish and or other aspects of, well, you know, there are big fish in the oceanic waters. And, you know, I mean, you know, you could take this, like, this little ridge at the bottom would be kind of like lobster bisque, okay? And so this would be like the ridge over where lobster bisque would be, okay? And so like then here's the top of the water, you know? For a very non-scale viewpoint, but yet at the same time, kind of good enough. And so that's just lobster bisque, that's it. And so I kind of figured, you know, military guys, especially guys that went into the water, mainly in the Gulf of Mexico area and anywhere along the Atlantic area of the oceanic waters, anywhere that the Atlantic would go, you know, not just the, you know, United States of America, because yeah, there is that reality. However, it's still the Atlantic. And so, you know, it is as it is. And I kind of figured, you know, especially those dot, dot, dot guys, they just wouldn't want, I mean, you know, comparatively, I'm sure I know there are certain types of dot, dot, dot guys that are like competition. And yet, you know, those types of dot, dot, dot guys who have met certain types that are like, well, you know, it, you know, you, you know, they pretty much have that sort of viewpoint. So, you know, whatever type of guy that some people could think of in those particular references regarding my type of scuba diving, you know, where it's just like, yeah, you really should be careful. However, so, you know, whatever dot, dot, dot guys would know in those particular references in the comparison to my style of, you know, scuba diving, you know, I would think it would be, you know, appreciated, because why would they want to have to deal with lobster bisque? You know, I mean, what was their mission work that they were doing not dangerous enough? Was what they were doing not enough? I mean, you know, if you really think about it, if there were to be any dot, dot, dot type of scuba diver, you know, whether Navy SEAL or, you know, whatever version of Special Forces of Coasties, or MARSOC and MARS, or, you know, recon guy. I mean, you know, because you'd really, you know, personally, I just haven't ever thought that that would be that big of a deal, because, you know, I mean, you wouldn't even have to be one of those guys. You could be a pogue in one of the branches. But yet at the same time, I just don't see how anybody would ever actually be jealous of having to deal with that. I mean, you know, if you really, really think about it. Because, you know, lobster bisque is just lobster bisque. And so, you know, and that's pretty. So just think, I took pictures of pretty things. So for those in reference to in Austin in the year 2010 and 2011, I had a bunch of people that tried to claim, oh, you know, you have better memories and so on and so forth in comparison. And so, you know, I took pictures of the pretty stuff when I had time. So, you know, if any individuals are like, no, it should have been so much prettier or something, I don't know. You know, so you have those references as to my journal blog, The Ornery PSA, on my website, www.susanmeling.com, which is the same as www.ladydorybell.com. And so anybody, I mean, it really doesn't matter regarding whether military, law enforcement, fire department, EMS, or civilian. I'm just going to point out there, I kind of figured, you know, there probably weren't many people who would be like, yeah, let's totally do that. That'd be fun. Mainly because I have dealt with it since I was a child and a teenager. And, you know, it took me a while to kind of get used to that in person, face to face in person. It's kind of, it was a lot, you know, and so I know that some people have this thing called pop culture, and while some people have a positive viewpoint of it, mainly probably because they have the whatever connection to in comparison. So, you know, my only comparison of pop culture is, well, first and foremost, Disney, G-rated sort of stuff, but remember, there's Disney where, you know, it's a small world ride for, you know, and then my biological mother singing It's a Small World, when every time having gone through that, and then in that particular reference additionally when it broke down, and having to sit there with the song still going the whole time for hours and hours and hours. And so, you know, whatever you consider Disney as a child or teenager or adult, I was a child when that happened, so. And it was already known as to certain aspects regarding my childhood. So I don't know, when you really think about it, if that's really the best example, and yet it kind of is. Because, you know, just think, you know, if any military guys were like, oh, you know, could have handled this, could have done this, so rawr, and stuff, you know, then you could just think, go ahead and, but by your own free will, of course, comparatively. Because that was not my choice to go on the It's a Small World ride at all. So, you know, then you gotta have someone like Anna singing. It's a week long, okay? You have to do it multiple times a day. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you have to wait in line too if you have the, you know, whatever. Because, you know, and then, because that was the only ride she would actually wait in line for, in comparison to going through the irony of ironies. And so, you know, instead of going through the handicapped area, no, you have to wait in line the whole time. And multiple times a day. Mm-hmm. You also have to have my biological sister with you at the same time, because, you know, you have to get that full experience, you know, because this is why I also don't understand. So, you know, here you go. So this is my Disney viewpoint, because while other people have made fun of me for, you know, having been raised where I was only allowed to watch G-rated movies and I got made fun of for not knowing pop culture, you know, again, this is my Disney experience. So, you know, so for the 7 days and 6 nights or whatever it was, you know, multiple times, a minimum of 3 to 5 per day, and then one of the days in the middle of the week, you know, pick one, and then it stops working and you have to stay there. And you have to be capable to tolerate listening to Anna sing in that high tone voice of soprano and stuff, and like her second soprano, first soprano, whatever it is, you know. It's a smile, that thing, but like in the so I've done what I could. And yet people didn't understand my viewpoint of Disney. They just focused on whatever they thought Disney was. I'm just saying, I have a very different viewpoint of Disney, apparently, because I really don't know what people think of when it comes to Disney, other than, yeah, okay, there's some movies. So I went to Florida, and that's where the Disney and stuff, and so, you know, I kind of, you know, I mean, you know, so those da-da-da guys, you know, if you can survive, I don't know why any military guy or law enforcement guy would ever be jealous of my work scuba diving, because you have to be capable to survive each and every second of every minute of every hour of every day of every week of every month of every year listening to Anna sing Second Spring. You know, at random points in time, okay? But it doesn't matter, the song. So think like, she was a skater, boy, says you later. That, okay? Throughout teenage years, too. As a starting point. I mean, I would think the dot, dot, dot guys might understand. I'm gonna go swim in the ocean. That's fine. This is fun. This is awesome. I'm gonna just keep swimming and swimming and swimming because that sounds so much better. The oceanic waves of the that sounds so much better than listening. Because think of the 1980s and 1990s songs, okay? People who know what the songs were in the 1980s and 1990s, okay? And maybe there's a reason why I don't remember them. To, you know, later in the 1990s, it's like, yeah, no diggity, no doubt. All right. In comparison to whatever else was, you know, why didn't I like Ace of Base? Why was I angry about? And then there's Old Tenet Presbyterian Church, which they know how my biological mother sang. I don't know if they actually needed to think about that, but think about it. Growing up in a house with Anna and hearing whatever songs from the 1980s, they also know how she was at church. So there is that, okay? And so, you know, that, okay? And then whatever song on the radio, whatever it was at that time, I want Coolio, I want Snoop Dogg, I want Biggie, I want Junior Mafia, I want Lil Kim, Dr. Dre, what is this Ace of Base? What is this? Why? I think it makes sense, but you know, Old Tenet Presbyterian Church, they didn't see that at all. I don't understand how, you know, sort of California love. And so I'm just saying, in regard, and just, just, and then think about if anybody's been around her when she did coding. You know she did that when I had to work. So then there's that. No. Dot, 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 guys, just think. And then there's the room next to the bedroom with all of the clocks and watches and all that stuff. Because remember, Mike went to the school of Bulova and was a watch fixer and repairer. And so just think of like hundreds of watches of different sizes and in paper bags. So you not only have the clicking sound from the gears, but you also have the clicking sound, you know, for certain hands movement because of the types of watches from the 1980s and 1990s and some of the older watches, which are very different than the lightweight watches now. And then the ones that went on the wall that have all sorts of songs, some of them every 15 minutes, some of them every half hour, some of them every hour, and then some of them, you know, so, you know, I don't understand, you know, I mean, maybe it takes a certain caliber of a person to be capable to be like, yeah, the oceanic waters in the Atlantic seem amazing. This is so schnuggles. This is the best. Like, I'm gonna just swim around. This is so much fun, you know, in comparison. I'm gonna listen to the waves and I'm gonna listen for the, you know, whatever. And oh, well, there's a seashell that just smacked somebody on the seashore, you know, whatever, that's fine. Sucks for them. Yeah, no, I'm just gonna keep swimming. Yes. As far as the water slamming against the jetties, that sounds so sweet. That's such beautiful music. Which brings a definitely different definition to that. Hills are alive, run, run, because all the waves, just with all that stuff. That seems so much calmer. That seems so much more. Oh, Fantasia's gonna play again. Awesome. In one room while Heidi is in the other room on. I don't know. This is why I don't understand, or if that is a plausibility of any, like a Navy SEAL or an MRR being like, you know, how dare a, you know, girl, female, go and do that by herself? Well, you know, why? What would there be to be jealous of? You'd have to be capable. Sure. So there's cold water and stuff like that at the surface. Yeah, depending where you're at. But you know, if you complained about that water, then you have to remember that the deeper you go, the colder the water can be. And so that's kind of common sense. And then the deeper you go, the bigger the species. So I listened to a guy who was talking with, I think it was Joe Rogan, and he was in one of these underwater houses. And I think he said something about like 60 feet or something, which was funny because, you know, are there boats that go nearby? And if there are boats that go nearby, well, there's this thing called downward draught. And so depending on the size of the boats that go nearby and that downward draught, well, you know, if you don't have to worry about the downward draught of the boats that go by, because, you know, let's say it's not little tugboats that go by. Let's say it's, you know, coasty boats. Okay, and a couple Navy boats, and sure, there could be civilian boats, but you know, size matters. And so if, like, you know, something like the Lexington can, you know, go along the top of the water area by without any of the issues regarding the downward draw, well, you know, you're probably more than 60 feet below the surface of the water. You probably are. I would think that would make sense. Then again, you know, I mean, it is as it is. I mean, you know, what would that matter? And so, while some people, I mean, I don't know if this has ever been a thing either. I have no idea if there, because in my thoughts, from 2009 to now in 2022, you know, why would anybody be jealous of my scuba diving? That's kind of like somebody saying they're jealous of my childhood, which I haven't ever had. So there's not ever been anybody who had told me that they were jealous of my childhood. And that was before my updates in the year 2019 through this year 2022. So that's kind of the same sort of viewpoint I've had in regards of my scuba diving, where it's like, you know, well, why would anybody be jealous of that? What amount of common sense would you need to actually, I mean, you know, because if there was ever any military guys that were like, we're going to totally get the answers, I could have just asked, you know, then there's that, because, you know, why not just ask? Though in that reference as well, you know, if the military guys were like, civilian recreational scuba divers, you're being whatever, rah, 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 rah. Then I got a problem. Yeah, because then at that point, it's one of those, they're the only individuals that you have in the area of on land that can actually assist you, and that wouldn't make sense to me. Because yes, while you have the recreational aspect, and yes, you have the lazy aspect as to the civilian capacity. However, it would be common sense to not be that way in that reference. And so while yes, I online have been as I've been, well, there are those, I'm sure. And mainly in the what is supposed to be consenting adult lifestyle communities that could easily say, yeah, there's, well, if you really want to go in a yelling match, that could happen. Or you could just have a discussion in comparison. Because, you know, in that comparison, however, if in reference to the Illinois situation, regarding that, you know, because why would I know that at the time frame of 2009, and then the situations regarding my daughter and my son and those factors, and, you know, anybody that would actually have, you know, children that they care about, you know, would be kind of irony of ironies, especially the knowledge of and those references and that respect that I've given this whole time, despite those particular factors as to what I've dealt with. And so while I just haven't ever thought about that, although because of E equals MC squares, posting in reference to that, well, you know, I have a little bit of a different viewpoint, I suppose, because, well, if the individuals that I look up to have whatever in those particular opinions in comparison, well, why? if it really is some sort of whatever, where military guys are like, you didn't graduate basic training. So I dealt with that from civilians. I also dealt with that in medical hold unit. And so there's that. As well as afterwards, you know, after I was taken off of a military installation and stuff like that. And so, you know, then Justice of the Peace and, you know, the birth of my son 1.5 years later, and the birth of my daughter 2.5 years later. And so, you know, I've done what I could, but I also wouldn't ever have thought beforehand, because why would I, as to that particular set of situations, because it would be so backwards to ever, in my opinion now, as to a review regarding 2022, because to me, I mean, that sort of viewpoint would just be, I mean, it literally didn't cross my mind until, you know, probably about a week or two ago, and in my thoughts it was like, because those military guys know what their basic training was. Those military guys know what their AIT and or equivalent of was. They know what their background stuff was, and they know what their lives were before they got into scuba diving as far as those particular factors. And so, you know, I just couldn't ever envision somebody that would ever actually be jealous of my scuba diving and or upset with it. Because again, that would require dealing with those factors. And so to me, it just wouldn't really, you know, ever cross my mind for going on 13 years now, because why would that ever be a thought process to someone such as myself? I mean, for the past 22 years, I have truthfully said, I didn't graduate basic training. And so, I mean, it would be really weird for any type of Navy SEALs or MRARs to ever be upset with someone who would maintain valor and only, you know, be truthful, in comparison especially to the situations regarding February of 2022. I mean, oh wait, that water coldness is so, I mean, you saw the ice if you went and looked at my videos, and I was just in a bathing suit to my scuba diving. And so in comparison to whatever possibilities as to those factors, it just wouldn't make any sense, because then there's the irony as to February in 2008, and that was the first time I was ever officially informed instead. And so of course that'd be important to take in consideration. And so, you know, those types of factors as to the prior works of, there's this one movie, which is an irony regarding, I can't remember, I think his name was Cuba Gooding Jr. I think that's who it was. And that actuality of was so amazing. And okay, I know that that's technically a type of pop culture. That was a stunning movie. I mean, it was extremely awe-inspiring to me as to those factors. And so, you know, those situations as to the conjunction of all the various situations that I personally dealt with and have been capable to progress as best as I could. And that is important, as best as I can. And so, you know, unlike Navy SEALs and MRARs who have like a team of people that they can, you know, train with and work with and rely on and all that, well, I didn't have that luxury. I mean, obviously, you know, there's my childhood and my teenage years and my biological adult years. And so that sort of situation would be important to take into consideration. Though, yet again, I wouldn't have ever thought of any military guy ever having any envy or jealousy over my scuba diving or any of the stuff, mainly because, well, I've dealt with it. It's kind of similar to the after effects from my head injury on Palm Sunday in 2000. I haven't ever understood people that would ever think that they had any right to get angry about the after effects of my head injury on Palm Sunday in 2000, unless they were angry at the individuals involved to that particular factor. That would make sense to me. In regards of people who have been angry as far as the subarachnoid hemorrhage in the frontal lobe of my brain that took 8.5 years to dissipate, I can understand why people would be angry at the people that didn't do the correct choices in comparison to ever regarding myself. Similarly, I've dealt with people who have been angry that I deal with headaches which doesn't make sense to me because I'm the one who has the headache pain, not them. They can be angry as to what occurred and the involvement of, and figure something to do in comparison, in my opinion, because why, I don't see how anyone would ever think it would make sense to ever be angry at me for what I dealt with and deal with. Same thing to my migraines, which are obviously more painful than headaches. And so it wouldn't ever make sense to me of any military guy, whether active duty or National Guard or reservist or veteran or even a dependent, wouldn't ever make any sense to me for any of those, or civilian, of course, though being angry as to my migraines because I'm the one who deals with them. And so I could understand them being angry as to the amount of treatments I went through and attempts I made and making different viewpoints to look at different avenues as to the pain levels. Similarly, I haven't ever understood anybody who had been angry at my memory deficits after my head injury on Palm Sunday in 2000, because I'm the one who deals with it. And so other people that have been angry, it didn't ever make sense to me because I thought that if anybody to be angry at, it would be any problem that was caused by any individual as to those particular factors as to how my memory deficits had become. I mean, I would think that that would make more sense as to common sense. Similarly to my cognitive disorders, it has not ever made any sense to me how anybody has ever been upset with me about my cognitive disorders that I deal with. It would make sense to me that other people would be upset as to why my cognitive disorders had been as they had been and figuring ways for betterment, similarly to the headaches, migraines, and memory deficits. Then additionally, it hasn't ever made sense to me how people have been angry that I went from college algebra with trigonometry and calculus to second grade math and been angry with me about it. That hasn't ever made any sense to me because in my opinion, it makes more sense to be upset with anybody that caused any needless problems in those capacities in the comparison of. And since I know you can't ever prevent a head injury or a coma or a subarachnoid hemorrhage in the frontal lobe of the brain or wherever, it just hasn't ever made any sense to me, to anyone that I've dealt with that was angry about that, because that's something they should be angry with other people about as to what occurred, in my opinion, as to those situations. Similarly, I haven't understood how people have been angry at me in reference to stuff such as, you know, what I've dealt with for quite some time. It would make sense for them to be angry at the individuals that caused those problems that could have assisted me in comparison. So then similarly to my scuba diving, I don't understand, and if I'm accurate in this, because it would be very difficult for me to understand anybody that would ever be jealous of my scuba diving. Whether in reference to earning 26 scuba diving certifications, mainly because of what I dealt with regarding males, mainly, some females here and there regarding the civilian sector, some recreational civilians, some lazy scuba diving civilians. In comparison, too, that didn't really make sense to me as to any possibility. There is the fact that Patty Stewart had brought up that something about tips, which didn't make sense to me because it was known how I got into scuba diving. And so if she had individuals who were given, like, you know, some people would know this metaphor in the what is supposed to be consenting adult lifestyle better. So somebody who has been involved with the lifestyle, though hasn't been honest about it to someone, and then they're right to be upset about that because, you know, whatever length of time, whatever level of You know, if there, especially if there's the knowledge, though, in comparison to scuba diving. And so bringing somebody in, and then instead of paying for the whatever, that particular course fee being a tip in comparison to whatever female or male, depending on, bringing into scuba diving, yet using the metaphor of, oh, let's try this something new together sort of thing. Because in my opinion, that would, I don't have words for what that would be other than I, in the scuba diving sector, well, that would be very recreational as far as scuba diving in the civilian sector, in my opinion. Similarly to how that would be lazy, in my opinion, regarding civilian scuba diving, mainly because how difficult would it actually be to just be honest about that scuba diving in comparison? Which I, you know, I wouldn't see that making sense, because you're supposed to be capable to trust the situation. And I could easily see females especially having problems with that, because, you know, scuba diving is where you literally descend into the water and you have this small little binky sized thing that goes into your mouth to breathe out of, and you can only get so much air or oxygen from it. And, you know, it comes in a hose that attaches to this metal thing that's attached to your back. And, you know, metal is usually heavy. And so you have to trust that that's going to breathe for you. And, you know, you'll be able to inhale and exhale safely and do that stuff. And sure, I understand there are tour guide situations. That doesn't change those particular factors, in my opinion, because you're still descending in the water, which doesn't matter if it's 30 feet down or 100 feet down, or in my situation, atmospheric measurements. So, you know, I might have a different viewpoint as to safety in those references because I'm more about life. And so that would be something to take in consideration, in my opinion. So again, I wouldn't understand envy in that reference. So if there were males who stirred up a bunch of females, as far as that's concerned, well then why would they know so much if it was just a brand new certification in that reference point, and that's just how that was, in comparison to actually, because I'm fairly certain the term would be considered double dipping for those individuals in comparison if it was used as a tip instead, and if I wrongly was blamed because Patty Stewart didn't actually tell people how that actually was going in reference to the different instructors as to that discussion, that would be a different set of situations that I'm sure would at some point in time clear themselves up because of those factors. That would be, again, not where I would be, but where Patty Stewart would be blamed and or the other scuba dive instructors in those references in comparison because of those common sense factors. So then there's, you know, whether a civilian and or whatever connection to, well, my scuba diving is my scuba diving and that's my work. So anybody who's seen my official YouTube videos, especially the majority of them, where I haven't, well, I should say I've maintained my composure in comparison, obviously. So, you know, I've been impacted because of these other situations and the culmination of, and if these needless problems didn't occur, then I wouldn't be angry, which anybody who has common sense could look at those particular factors, and if they had common sense would see why I would have the right to be angry in any of those capacities, especially as to whatever time. So, you know, it's not just 2009, it's the 1980s all the way through to 2009. Obviously, anybody who has common sense and intelligence would know that. So 2010 would be the 1980s into the 1990s into the 2000s into the 2010 point, because obviously, it would obviously make sense. I shouldn't have to actually explain that. That would make plenty of sense to, well, anybody that would have common sense. And so, you know, I personally didn't see how any, whether active duty, National Guard, reservist, dependent, and or civilian could ever have any envy regarding myself or my scuba diving, mainly because I know what my life has been that led up to that point in time, and so on and so forth. So it just doesn't really register to make any sense whatsoever that anybody would be envious of any aspect, because remember, you have to have each and every second of each and every minute of each and every hour of each and every day of each and every week of each and every month of each and every year of each and every decade that I've been alive. And so, you know, to whatever point of. And so you can't just cherry pick as to any aspect of, in my opinion, because of what it takes to build that. So there's that lack of understanding as to any possibility to ever think that there'd ever be anything to be jealous or envious of. I figured, you know, if there's appreciation because you didn't have to deal with that, you know, and it would be capable to be seen in reference to, you know, a lot of in-person, face-to-face, in-person situations. So in regards of myself, I know what I've handled. So sure, I could come across to some as modest or quiet, but I also deal with headaches and migraines. And the modesty, well, you know, I grew up a certain way. I'm not in the lottery. So there's that common sense factor of a difference. If anybody had any thought that that would be the same, because I don't know why anybody would ever think that that would be the same. Similarly to the underground forming volcano heat to make the air bubbles, but the water boiling situation compared to a volcano on land, the temperature difference, smidgen different. And so, you know, it would make sense to me why, you know, if I had to ever evaluate a situation, because I've met some .. guys, and they, you know, they've usually been really laid back. They probably might recognize a few things in that reference. And so, you know, it kind of, depending on, of course, but again, I couldn't ever see where anybody would be jealous or envious at all. Again, mainly because I know what it took to deal with that. So I was listening to a Joe Rogan Experience video clip, and he and another guy were talking about the World War II compared to World War I, compared to Korean War, and compared to Vietnam War, as well as the more current Iraq and Afghanistan war situation. And, you know, so if any viewpoint regarding my scuba diving, well, if in reference to World War II's viewpoint in the general public, it's probably because we won. That's probably why. And so, you know, there's blood and treasure. And so in reference to the Korean War and Vietnam War, well, I could understand why some people wouldn't have the public perception as to the same regarding World War II. Mainly because we won World War II. And so, you know, politics shouldn't be involved in war at all. Because when you have the politics involved with war, you have those situations. So it makes sense to me in reference to the difference of opinion, in my opinion. However, it doesn't change the fact that despite the viewpoint of the aspects of, including Desert Shield and Desert Storm, it makes sense to me to still be appreciative of my constitutional rights, which those particular factors, you know, well, there are the realities as to those particular guys, those .. types. So where they would have the capacity to actually discuss things because of the knowledge regarding a few situations in comparison to the normalcy, and instead of the fluffy bunny type of psychologist in that particular reference. Well, I am an ordained reverend, and so the difference in that capacity. So I also, there's that viewpoint of that my Medal of Honor art project, artwork. And so I figured that guys would actually appreciate that in, you know, comparison, because instead of, well, other people's opinions, because of the viewpoint and actually being inspired, so it didn't matter which war they were from, as far as my Medal of Honor art project regarding the symbol, those particular factors as to those situations were still inspiring. So to me, you know, it would be weird, especially with as many people who are into pop culture, ever having an issue regarding my Medal of Honor art project artwork. It would make sense to me if it, you know, wasn't a problem, but I haven't really had any one way or another. I've had some positive in that regard, though it is as it is in those references. Though in conjunction to my scuba diving, it's also one of those, well, that, well, it wasn't something other people had to deal with to learn how to do. You have to have certain capabilities. And so I don't understand if there were to ever be that sort of viewpoint. And so in regards of the combined factors, especially as to Memorial Day, as to the 30th of May, 2022, it would be weird to me any military guy who would ever be upset regarding my own needs being taken care of, as to what I've put forward on my journal blog, The Ornery PSA, on my website, www.susanneeling.com, which is the same as www.ladydorybell.com, mainly because, especially with the updates as to those particular factors. And so it just wouldn't ever make sense to me if there would ever actually be any issues in those references. Because, you know, whether regarding my scuba diving and or my Medal of Honor art project artwork, it really wouldn't make sense in those references because, well, I'm the one who's done all the work, yet again. And so I haven't ever been asked as far as that was concerned, because of verification situations. And so if anybody was ever upset because of, you know, the modern day book, for an example, well, and you can go to my book section on my website, www.susanneeling.com, which is the same as www.ladydorybell.com, that wouldn't make sense to me, mainly especially if there were any, having read what I dealt with in that combined factor. Because, you know, from 2009 through even to this year of 2022, could have discussed it. I'm sure there may have been a person or two who could have asked me questions in genuine truth. Similarly, in comparison, then there's the aspects as to, well, it is the Department of Defense. And so then there's the formation of the Space Force. And so, you know, E equals MC squared has been out more often as far as different statements and in the news and stuff like that with that SpaceX stuff. And then Mr. Bezos has been talking about Blue Origin and that sort of stuff. And then there's NASA, a few factors that have kind of, you know, And then 45 and 47 regarding Donald J. Trump and Mike Pence with the administrations and the war, leading up to. It seems, you know, that Space Force thing would make sense. And so, you know, but again, the Navy boat guys to the stuff overhead. And then if it was ever an issue because I'm a biological female, well, I didn't ever actually look up any of the Navy SEAL training, nor did I ever look up any of the, I called them recon this whole time because I thought they were recon. I didn't realize there's recon and then there's MRA or whatever. I didn't have that knowledge, as I've explained in my official YouTube videos. Make sure to like my official YouTube videos and subscribe to my official YouTube channel. And if you're gonna leave a comment, make sure to have etiquette and respect. However, I didn't look that up before. I actually had no idea that that was anything remotely close in any capacity up. I just was taking care of what I needed to. And then there's McCoy Elementary School in Carrollton, Texas. And you know, I mean, it's just whatever quarries and reservoirs and lakes and Gulf of Mexico and Atlantic area, the oceanic waters. So if there was any issues regarding those particulars, I mean, it wasn't like I was going to the Gulf of Mexico when my son and my daughter were in school during the weekend. And even if in regards of Florida, well, there wasn't any recreational aspects for me whatsoever. So then there's that regarding certain types of those housewives. In those particular references in regards of attention. And so in comparison, you know, there's just work that I was taking care of. And I know some people might have whatever thoughts because I didn't graduate basic training and I'm just a biological female and I look as I do and so on and so forth in comparison. And so, you know, I was just cleaning out of water, so those weren't a problem, and you know, guys didn't have to deal with that. Same thing with the Gulf of Mexico, same thing with the hot springs and the lakes, the ocean. So, I personally have had the viewpoint that there wouldn't ever be anything to be envious of. At all, whatsoever. I mean, really think about it. Almost every weekend or every other weekend, it's not like I was going out to Boca. I was going out to Terrell, Texas, or I was going out to Huntsville, Texas, or I was going out to Lake Travis area in Austin, Texas. Or I was going to the Aquarena Hot Springs in San Marcos, Texas. Or I was going out to wherever other in Texas. So if that's considered luxury to, you know, pinch a tent and eat from MREs, mainly because I had my VW Beetle Bumblebee car, the food wouldn't spoil. I could eat it without any issues. It was non-perishable. It was, you know, the common sense. Didn't have to refrigerate it, unlike a Lunchable. Again, VW Beetle, Bumblebee car, convertible with that trunk. It's not the same trunk as the old VW Beetle, just so that's known, because where the trunk is. And then, you know, made sense to me. Because, you know, common sense is important. And so, you know, then there's the miles from the area to wherever there would be food. And then if I had leftovers, just made sense to have memory. Does that seem like common sense? But you know, if there are those who have considered that to be luxury, well, you know, that'd be their opinions. As far as that's concerned. And then, you know, sure, there were times that other people brought their own food or we went and picked up food or whatever it was. That was their choices. I always had MREs. And so, you know, that's kind of a common sense factor. And so, you know, then there's those situations regarding my cavern scuba diving certification and who actually was my cavern scuba diving certification instructor in comparison. And so if there was that particular set of needless problems because of, you know, why would I ever know anything about that whatsoever? I mean, that would be common sense yet again in comparison to those factors. But hey, today is the 30th of May, 2022, and in 6 days, on the 6th of June, 2022, Verizon, AT&T, T-Mobile, and Sprint will be completely merged together as far as all that's concerned. So cool. Awesome, regarding that's a lot of work that would take, and assist in regards to how the U.S. Space Force has been formulated. So again, I don't know if there are pop culture references in a different capacity compared to, though there's that. And so if there were those who were jealous and or envious, I don't know why, mainly because I'm the one who deals with it. It makes sense to be angry at other stuff and then going to fix and repair that. That makes sense to me because, you know, you could take that anger and do something more positive with it. And if you ever have questions, you probably have people to ask. Comparison, so that's cool. Pretty cool to actually have someone in person, face to face in person, that you could go speak with and actually ask. That seems, and you might not even get yelled at or talked down to or whatever as to the comparison, you know, in that hypothetical, or you know, those Ten Commandments actually being followed. And so that possibility, you know. However, it is as it is regarding those situations. So I just haven't ever really thought about that, though I decided to create my official YouTube video regarding that because, you know, it just didn't seem like there would ever really be any military guy who would ever have an issue with my work unless it was out of actual care. An actual concern, because, you know, I mean, I don't know if there's anybody who's ever in that capacity, you know, in comparison to what occurred in reference to my son and my daughter and I as my only family that I ever had. In that way, so I only gave birth to one son, I only gave birth to one daughter. And despite the situations as to how I got pregnant, I still did what I could to take care of my son and my daughter. And I actually enjoyed being a mom in comparison to what some people might assume instead. Because, you know, if you assumed because of the knowledge as to, well, how about actually doing something that would have actually assisted me in comparison, if that's a situation regarding the needless separation of my son, my daughter, and I as a family, because that's probably hypothetically capable to be shown as more detrimental. Because why would anybody who would ever think that that would be acceptable in that capacity instead? I have worked as much as I have, as best as I could, and I did what I could to actually protect and defend my son and my daughter. Though I know I look as I do and other people's opinions in that hypothetical. However, that again would require actually asking me. Though if it was asked of everybody else in comparison, well then there's those situations, which I don't actually understand why anyone would be so ignorant if you actually could just ask. Because, especially if you don't have a military connection, because if you have a military connection, as far as that's concerned, but if you don't have a military connection, I wouldn't be capable to ever understand the aspects of regarding just simply asking at all. That just wouldn't make sense to me ever, because you wouldn't have the constraints of the military stuff as a civilian. And if that was ever done by civilians, that wouldn't ever make sense to me, because you don't have that same situation as military guys. And so then there's the, if a bunch of civilians wanted to do that and thought that they would, you know, get to the whatever. Just my son, my daughter, and I as a family. That's it. Just my life. Just, you know, my home. So you can, you know, go read my journal blog, The Ornery PSA. As far as those updates about my childhood, my teenage years, my biological adult years. So that just, you know, I mean, you know, in regards of Austin in 2010 and 2011 that wanted to try to claim that my childhood and my teenage years were better for whatever thoughts they had. So there's those updates. So, again, I haven't ever really understood any aspect of a few things that I've dealt with as far as certain types of people. Though that aspect regarding military guys, that, you know, that wouldn't make sense to me of any military guy that would ever be jealous. Whether in the Army or the Air Force or the Coast Guard or the Marine Corps or the Navy, just wouldn't seem any common sense to me. Again, mainly because I dealt with it. So, you know, I mean, that just wouldn't ever make sense at all whatsoever to me. And at all. And there's the, I've had people tell me that they've been jealous of me, and I've had to tell them, don't be jealous. And they were like, no, totally am. You know, like that childish sort of situation. It's like, no, really, don't. Don't be jealous. There's really nothing to be jealous of. And a bunch of, and it was usually females. Yeah, right. You don't know. I know what there's to be jealous of. You know, no, no. And then, you know, certain types of males had tried that as well. And when it came to those certain types of males, it was one of those, no, really, don't be jealous. And they would try to give me what they thought was something to be jealous of. And I'd just rebuttal every point. And then they got angry because I was correct. And that just didn't make sense, because why would you be angry that I was correct? If you're gonna be angry, you should probably be angry at yourself in comparison to being angry any other way, because that doesn't make sense to me. You know, because I, I have reviewed quite a few things that I have been angry at myself for. So I've got my saying on my journal blog, The Ordinary PSA. It's on my website, www.susanmeeling.com, which is the same as www.ladydorybell.com. And so with my saying, you know, I mean, if anybody's read that, it's, I mean, if other people interpreted it as, I don't know what they'd interpret it as. However, I mean, I've evaluated a few things and I've been a smidgen angry that I had a head injury on Palm Sunday in 2000. So, can't be the only person who's been angry for having a head injury or having been in a coma or dealing with pain or anything like that. I would think that'd probably be a common sense situation. However, you know, is as it is. So that's that. So it is, it is as it is. So, my personal opinion. So if individuals have had issues with how civilians could have asked, if they told you that they asked, well, they told you that. So if you asked civilians and they told you something else, so let's say there were military guys and they went and spoke with civilians and the civilians were sent to whatever and they told whatever, well, Ten Commandments are important. So there's that. And if other people had issues believing the after effects of my head injury and thought that hinting in comparison to just being honest and straightforward and to the point with etiquette and respect and wanted to, you know, use code or whatever in a different capacity instead, well, that seems weird to me. You know, I mean, I had a head injury and I've got memory deficits and cognitive disorders. So if that was instead, that's something else in that regard. That doesn't make much sense in my opinion to do that way, especially if you could just be honest and ask. So, you know, but I also don't play games of any type. So I suppose it depends on those factors. Anyway, just bringing that up regarding today, Memorial Day, you know, and a combined factor situations. And so those time frames are important, you know, so like my journal blog update starting in 2019. On my website, www.susanmeeling.com, same as www.ladydorybell.com. Well, that's when I literally remembered. So, sure, I had the knowledge. That doesn't change the fact that I didn't remember until when I started writing about it. That's why in my journal blog, The Ordinary PSA, there's different days with different journal blogs. Because that's when I remembered, if I didn't already put it in writing beforehand in my fact-based books and or discussed. So that in-person, face-to-face, in-person situation. So if that's the hypotheticals for certain situations, well, that's an issue those people to work through, because those Ten Commandments are important, integrity is important, honor is important. Honesty is important, truth is important. So I do appreciate if there are any people who actually support me. I mean, I, because I don't have that in-person, face-to-face, in-person situation, because of those after effects of my head injury on Palm Sunday in 2000. And because I've done everything that I've done on my own because of how that's been, well, I do appreciate it. It's not that I don't. I do appreciate, I do have gratitude. There are the facts, though, that the after effects of my head injury are as they are. And so if there were those, such as in CID, who didn't accept the reality as to what I deal with, well, my updates from my journal blog, The Ordinary PSA, probably compared to whatever information, and not just in regards of finding A and finding the silver lining, though in reference to the time between 2000 to this year of 2022, well, you know, whenever I woke up from my coma, from my head injury on Palm Sunday in 2000, any information that I have written about and or given a sermon, lecture, monologue, what have you about, from the time frame since whatever point in time, though the information being from the year 2000 and before, being added to as far as the actualities of at some point in time thereafter, well, then you have a baseline as to the actual damages to the after effects of my head injury on Palm Sunday in 2000. And you have the baseline in reference to the truth. And so there are those factors that accept accountability, because sure, I like to go to dance. Nothing more. But you know, if that energetic situation, I can't be around certain things because I actually do pick up on energy. And so if certain situations are in that hypothetical, I can't deal with that. Reality. And so, well, then I guess that would be the G-rated movie situation to take in consideration in comparison to the Disney stuff. So if that has to do anything with CID, well, then just think of all the stuff that I dealt with as a biological female for this length of time. And then, you know, on U.S. soil for the length of time since the year 2000. And so, and or, you know, the year of 1996 because of Marine and Science Technology School, because if it had to do with that. That's, again, not my fault. That's different. Be my biological mother, biological father, and biological sister's fault. In well, biological mother and biological father, though in part biological sister because of her wanting to run away from certain things. As far as responsibility and accountability for her stupidity, which anybody who's met her in person, face-to-face in person, they would know as to how that goes in comparison to myself. So it's the year 2019, the year 2020, the year 2021, and the year 2022. So maybe those preconceptions, and this is important about thou shalt not bear false witness against your neighbor, thou shalt be truthful, thou shalt not blaspheme, so on and so forth. Really important. Really, truthfully important. So, if that's a situation as far as my exoneration, that'd be great. However, those other factors, that doesn't change anything at all regarding my scuba diving, mainly because it doesn't change the fact that my scuba diving is my scuba diving. That's pretty much the facts. But you'd think that there'd be appreciation for that because nobody else had to actually deal with that. Because I've seen in person, face to whatever you want to call it, in person, maybe my perspective is a smidgen different. So those who know pop culture and do whatever dress ups, well, you know that that is a dress up costume in comparison to reality. So while sure there's like that Renaissance fair type and whatever in those capacities, well, you know and have the understanding and comprehend if there are those factors of that they're dressed up in whatever costume. In comparison to, for example, of my water stuff, in comparison, just as somebody would know that that would be someone in a costume or whatever, in comparison, I would know the reality. So that reality, I would know because of my reality. So in that difference of anybody that hypothetically has ever been jealous, and well, again, think about the fact that you know that you've had whatever situations and whatever dress up sort of whatever, in comparison to the reality. So for example, there was a situation in Portland, Oregon. Took my son somewhere and there was Marvin the Martian, or a guy dressed up as Marvin the Martian, I should say. And so I knew that that was a guy dressed up as Marvin the Martian. I knew that there was a human being underneath that. I don't know who at all. And that is as it is. However, that's whatever. In that same instance, when I was in the water, wherever, whether in my childhood or my teenage years, or my biological adult years, which includes scuba diving and swimming. Well, similar to how I knew that that guy who was dressed up in the Marvin the Martian costume was a guy dressed up in the Marvin the Martian costume, but the shorter words of, oh, it's Marvin the Martian aspects. Well, I knew when I went in the water what I was gonna go take care of and handle. So again, I knew that this guy was all dressed up and whatever, whatever. And similarly to knowing that, when I went to Clear Springs and or the quarry and or Hot Springs and or whatever lake and or the Gulf of Mexico and or the Atlantic area of the ocean after being a biological adult, yeah, I knew what I was dealing with. Not my fault that other people didn't ask me. That's their fault. So you could be angry at those people. That's what you could do if that's a situation in comparison, because that's not my fault. I made attempts, as I've explained. So, but yet again, in regards of my Medal of Honor art project artwork, well, I've done a lot of updating from the time frame of 2019 to now in 2022. I've also worked on a whole bunch of official YouTube videos of mine. Again, subscribe to my official YouTube channel as well as like my official YouTube videos. And if you're gonna leave a comment, make sure to have etiquette and respect. And I've authored a couple more books. So, you know, I drove around a lot in the year of 2019 and 2020 and 2021 without assistance additionally to take in consideration. You know, there wasn't anybody that contacted me and asked me if I needed any assistance regarding anything, which includes quite a few situations. So, you know, etiquette and respect. So I haven't ever had that. There's not ever been a point in time or anybody's ever asked me if I needed something or wanted anything or even brought it up as an option, as like, here's the equivalent of a menu, and here's a menu of options, and here you go, in the honest aspects of that hasn't occurred. So, you know, anybody who might be jealous or envious, I don't know how, yet again. That's the facts. So, thanks for tuning in. And in regards of my style of scuba diving, well, there's obviously the difference that, again, if there are those who didn't ask me who could have, and that requires asking me in person, face to face, in person, utilizing words audibly to have an actual discussion in comparison to ever thinking that just doing some version of exactly what I brought up in the original updates of my journal blog on my website, www.susanmeeling.com, which is the same as www.ladydorybell.com, in the ornery PSA as to, well, if you decided to play games regarding failsafe in comparison to actually utilizing your mouth to formulate sentences and have actual words come out of your mouth while having an actual discussion with etiquette and respect when in person, face to face, in person with me, then you have no one to blame but yourselves. Because that's your fault. That's not my fault. And so, that Ten Commandments is so important. So if other people claimed that they did, and then they didn't, or they wanted to say they were doing the fail-safe thing, which literally in the title, it says science fiction. Mm-hmm. So, sure, could be some prophecy. There's no denying that. However, I still authored it in science fiction. Just what I thought was science fiction, because the culmination of stuff that I read as to a description of what science fiction would be considered as. So if it's considered something else, I wouldn't know. Nonetheless, learning my scuba diving, I wouldn't understand, or even in regards of herbing and or any other situation, I wouldn't understand why anybody'd actually be jealous of that. That's my personal opinion. And again, it's because I dealt with that in person, face to face, in person. So because I dealt with that face to face, in person, regarding a few situations, depending on the factors of, and what you consider, because there are certain other site situations, there's that. So, just haven't ever seen where anybody could ever be jealous or envious of me, even when people have said so. I just didn't ever see it, because I know what I've experienced in my life. So, but they also didn't elaborate as to what they would actually be in that consideration. So that's another factor to the reality. Would actually have to be informed to me as to, because people usually just said it in a generalized way, and in a generalized way, I haven't been capable to ever understand that, so, or see that. So if there are certain specifics, there's very few times when that's ever been a discussion, and brief, very brief discussion. Usually it ended with, well, you should have better memories than that. And so that's another standpoint. So you guys have a good day. So if anybody had tried, despite my warnings against, and having gone over my childhood and my teenage years regarding going out to the oceanic waters, despite being minimal, it still is the truth. Those situations, well, if I've gone over this, if one time of something, whatever, well, then that two times is a coinky dink and three times is a pattern. So, whatever that pattern might be. You guys have a good day. Today is the 30th of May, 2022. And it's Memorial Day.